The bodies, the mortal remains have now landed as we're looking at the pictures, Nair, of the Special Indian Air Force's aircraft, the flight that has just landed at the Kochi airport. Chief Minister himself, who is present there, Union Minister Suresh Gopi also present. And the response that came in from the Government of India, first sending across the MOS also to look into the affairs, the arrangements that to be made with this special flight that was carrying the mortal remains of nearly 45 Indian citizens who unfortunately became victims of that fire tragedy in Kuwait that mainly housed labor workers. And now their bodies are now being taken out, their mortal remains that are taken out. The MOS himself, who is present on board the flight that had departed from Kuwait and has now landed at the Kochi airport. Of course, several questions when it comes to the standard of living and working that is now being questioned on part of the Kuwaiti authorities as well. Prime Minister Modi himself, who was closely monitoring the situation and at the first step instructed the minister to himself be a part of the arrangements till the time the bodies are brought back home and thereafter are sent across to their native places, to their respective homes. The Chief Minister himself, who is present there, Pinaray Vijayan, as many of the citizens who have lost their lives in this tragedy hail from Kerala. The others are also from the state of Tamil Nadu. The families there are distraught. Some of them had these individuals who were the lone breadwinners of the family, and they were working in Kuwait for over a decade now. And arrangements that you can see that has been made at the Kochi airport itself when it comes to the mortal remains that are now being brought back. Appropriate respects that would be paid to the individuals who have lost their lives, Imran, and thereafter we are told that the bodies will be given to their respective families.
Airport itself, the state government has made arrangements to give the final rites will be performed, and after that, with a police escort, the bodies in the ambulances will be sent back to the respective family members. Now, some of the family members have said that they will keep the body in the mortuary because of the state of condition of the bodies. So it will be, and tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock, they'll receive the bodies, like we say, the Vilukos family here at Kollam. And it will be brought to the family member's house here till 10 o'clock. People can pay their last respect. And after that, it will be taken for to perform the final rites. And this is the arrangement the state government has made. In fact, they sent out a message last night itself when they got to know that the plane is landing today. Chief Minister had left for Kollam around 8 in the morning because the plane was supposed to land at 8:30.
But it got delayed, but it's landed now. And the state of funerals, official state funeral will perform there, where the state government will pay the last respects to the 23 people who died in the accident tragedy from Kerala in Kuwait, over which now an entire issue has found about the question about the safety and living conditions of the workers there. And after the state funeral, where even Union Minister Suresh Gopi is also there, the bodies escorted by cops will be sent in special ambulances to their respective family members, where they're eagerly waiting to receive them. This is the procedure what the state government announced. In fact, yesterday is 11 o'clock itself, the Chief Minister had called for a special urgent meeting over this issue, and where all the district officials concerned with that, especially Pathanthitta, Kollam and others, Kasargod, where the bulk of the victims come from. Pathanthitta 6 are there, Kollam 4, and others from 2 from Kasargod, and other also neighboring district Karnataka also there. So these districts, the Chief Minister had a meeting with the SP and the DC of these areas to ensure they immediately go and meet the family members. Yesterday, the ministers, the health minister and other ministers also came and met the family members, assuaged them, and also announced a compensation for the family and said that all necessary assistance will be provided. And now the process is on. All the families are eagerly waiting for the bodies to be to reach their family home so that they can give them a dignified burial. As we speak, the Chief Minister along with the Health Minister and Union Minister Suresh Gopi are there at the airport to receive the bodies and give them a state funeral. And after that, escorted by police, the ambulances will head back to the respective family members' house.
Right, because Imran, the questions that are also being raised on the kind of conditions that the Indian workers, they live in and they work in. And when it comes to the Gulf, that has been a popular choice, especially when it comes to Indians who hail from the southern part to work there for better job opportunities, better living standards. But it seems that the living standards that have been provided to them at Gulf are not much, looking at how they were all cramped up in the building. And most of them lost their lives while they were sleeping. They were charred to death.
Well, absolutely. For almost for 3 to 4 decades, there has been Indians, especially from the state of Kerala, flocking to Gulf after the Gulf hit the economic boom. And the bulk of the workforce who work there in Gulf GCC countries are Keralites or Malayalis, popularly referred to them as. And they work in the both nursing industries, the social service industries, and the service industry, especially for food and beverages. They make up the bulk of the jobs there. And their conditions, or living conditions, have always been a issue and a question by the human rights activists and watch, and especially several Amnesty International reports are also there about the highlighting the plight of the workers there with inhuman living conditions and not adequate pay and all these other issues. But despite that, people flock because of the job opportunities it provided. But this tragedy, however, has angered the people there, questioning, you know, also even putting a central government to step in. And this time, as the Kuwait government said, that they will look into this issue and they also initiated inquiry. Sir, काफी लोग केरला से गल्फ कंट्रीज में काम करते हैं और इस बार पहली बार इतना बड़ा ट्रेजेडी भी हुआ है.
नहीं हुआ है।
आप कैसे लिविंग कंडीशंस कैसे वहां पर जो काम करने का तरीका है मलयालम में बोलिए आप मलयालम में बोलिए सर लिविंग कंडीशंस तो वर्कर्स गल्फ का कैसे
कोई तो कोई कंपनी तो अच्छा है कोई कंपनी थोड़ा फर्क है ये बस ऐसा है लेकिन
So there you see some saying that some companies they work take care of the workers, some do not. But overall, people have been questioning about the living conditions. Sir, आप गल्फ में जो living conditions है, कर्नाटक कुवैत गवर्नमेंट ने भी बोला है कि वो inquiry report बनाएगा. लेकिन आप क्या चाहते हैं कि और government इस पर effort करे ताकि वहाँ का जो workers है वहाँ का living conditions उस पर और उस पर ध्यान दें.
उधर मैं कुवैत में 5 साल पहले काम किया. उधर अच्छा है, labor contract पूरा अच्छा है. अभी फर्स्ट टाइम ऐसा प्रॉब्लम फर्स्ट टाइम आया. अभी वो लोग ठीक करेगा. अभी
आपको उम्मीद है कि ठीक होगा.
Well, the grieving, distraught families there are waiting as far as their loved ones are concerned because they are now come back in a coffin. The mortal remains that will be arranged at the Cochin International at the Cochin Airport that we are looking at the special Indian Air Force flight that has just landed, and the mortal remains that are now being brought out as we are getting you the live pictures from the airport itself, where Chief Minister and Union Ministers are present, continuously getting you those pictures and updates, and of course from the families and how they have been going through this very difficult and painful time. Back after a short break.